May the name of Jesus be praised, both now and forever. Welcome, beloved of God. This is Father Michael, along with the rest of the team. Thank you for joining us in prayer. You're praying with the God Minute. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips.
And my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 9. Lift my spirits that I may be of use. I give thanks with my whole heart for every rock of the earth, every star of the sky. I will rejoice in you and be glad and sing psalms to your name, O Most High.
I praise you for your presence in my heart, O God, which makes me strong and unafraid. You are a refuge for the oppressed and troubled. Those who put their trust in you are comforted.
Whisper in my heart, O God, for I am tormented by difficulties and discouraged by the awful state of the world.
Lift my spirits so that I may be of use. And trap the wicked with the works of their own hands. Help me to set things right, so that the needy are not forgotten and the poor have hope.
For we were created in your image, and our life should be a blessing to us all.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
A reading from St. Paul's letter to the Ephesians, chapter 3, verses 14 to 19. Brothers and sisters, I kneel before the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named, that he may grant you to be strengthened with power through his Spirit, and that Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, and that you, rooted and grounded in love, may have the power to know the love of Christ. The Word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Love endures everything. Love is stronger than death. Love fears nothing. These words were written by Saint Faustina, whose feast we celebrate today, and they surely speak to us of the love of Jesus, thus capturing what I'd like to reflect on today. A story is told about a person in a foreign country who, as he walked down the street one night, neared a stranger whistling a tune. The first person knew the melody, so he began whistling it too. The other man looked startled at first, but then realized the two had a common bond. They stopped for an instant, hugged each other, and then each continued on his way. What drew them together in that brief moment? It was the song, What a Friend We Have in Jesus. Faith in Jesus breaks down all barriers. Love of God is a relationship that immediately unites believers to each other in ways that nothing else can. As we all know, our world today is constantly changing. In these tumultuous times, we each need a fixed point of reference. For the believer, the love of God is this North Star, which does not move. The prophet Jeremiah in chapter 31, verse 3, notes God saying, "I have loved you with an everlasting love." Indeed, nothing can separate us from God's love. Let's anchor ourselves in God alone. Remember, too, that God does not love us because we are good. God loves us because God is good. Nothing we humans do can inhibit, impact, decrease, or increase God's love for us. In truth, following Jesus is an option, a choice, and we are totally free to say yes or no or maybe. We don't have to do this to make God love us. That's already taken care of. We do it to love God back and to love what God loves and how God loves. Again, in the words of Saint Faustina, pure love knows that only one thing is needed to please God: to do even the smallest things out of great love, love, and always love.
Let us continue to pray in our prayer today for all of our sisters and brothers who are devastated by natural disasters, and that as we pray, we might unite ourselves in love with them and their struggle. In the words of Jesus, then, we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we turn to you with grateful hearts for what we have, and with great anticipation for what is yet to be. Bless us and give us a spirit of joy and peace, knowing that you are the foundation of our lives. Strengthen us and bless us with your presence now and forever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thanks, everyone, for praying with us today. Be good to yourself and one another, and we'll see you tomorrow.